So, hi there. Can you introduce yourself and your creative background?
Yeah, my name's Sonam Tobgyal. I'm an alternative process photographer slash artist. I graduated university a year ago, 2020, in photojournalism and documentary photography. And that sort of formed the basis of my practice. But I like to sort of use alternative processes, so sort of like less commonly used styles of photography to try and tell documentary stories in a slightly visually different way, you know, in a slightly, yeah.
And what is it about photography that attracted you to the course or the profession?
I've been taking photos for as long as I can remember, really. There's something about telling a story using real images, you know, things that people can relate to and things that people can't relate to, and using real life to tell that story. You know, I really like that sort of ultra realist medium.
And what are some of the alternative ways that you take photographs?
So the last project I was working on was using cyanotypes and 360 degree photography. Mm-hmm. So it's cyanotype is a sort of it's a process of printing photographs on that creates this blue monochrome imagery. Oh yeah, I'm sure you know what it is. But yeah, so I sort of like taking this. It's a sort of a bit functionally redundant, but it has historical links to certain points and subjects that I was trying to relay, and I thought it fit quite nicely with the medium. Mm-hmm. And then in this latest project, I've been using solographs, which is these wacky pinhole cameras that track the movement of the sun through the sky in a single image, and you end up with these vibrant solar arcs that everyone will be able to see soon.
Well, that sounds pretty cool. I only actually found out what cyanotype was recently with another project from Totally Thames, so before that I was a novice.
Oh, nice. Yeah, I saw it. It's cool. It's got nice links to, because you have to use water as well, so it always has nice connections to the river and to nature.
So tell us about your latest project for Totally Thames, In the Offing, the Sea and Sky Were Welded.
Yeah, so I got the name from, it's a quote taken out of Joseph Conrad's Heart of Darkness. And at the start of the book, there's lots of descriptive writing sort of about the journeying down the Thames and sort of leaving. And I just felt like this quote sort of really accurately presented this sort of idea of transition and development and the fusing of both the sea and the land and how that sort of connects to our relationship with nature. Mm-hmm. So the project originally started when I was over lockdown. I spent a lot of time visiting the Thames because it's just quite a nice place to be when everyone was stuck, and you know, it's kind of one of the only places you could go. And I noticed that quite a lot of people were doing the same. And that got me thinking about how the River Thames sort of epitomizes this eternal force, this eternal stream that travels constantly, no matter what's going on in the greater world or no matter what developments are happening around. You have this vein that pulses through London or through a lot of the country, and how that can kind of be a sort of source of comfort for a lot of people. And I think for me anyway, that was a lot of the reason why I was going down to the Thames, because you could sit there and, you know, it almost felt like we were living a normal life. And yeah, so I thought this sort of idea of progression and transition was so inspiring that I felt like I wanted to try and depict that through a photo project. And then stumbling into solographs, it just seemed like the best suited way to depict that. You know, you have a very visual depiction of what a time passing sort of looks like. You know? Mm-hmm.
Yeah, it's with the Thames, I guess during COVID it was such a crazy time. It was kind of like that one constant for a lot of people. So I can see why everyone kind of flocked to it. So what are some of the highlights from working on this project for you?
Well, working with Totally Thames has been amazing. They've been really supportive. It's nice to have a little bit of infrastructure sort of behind the project to help push it along. They were still very free and nice to work with. They didn't really try and dictate anything. but they were very supportive in every sort of step that I needed to go on. It was amazing. I spent a lot of time in Silvertown and in little sections down the Thames that I never thought I would be in. It all started in Tilbury and Gravesend, which are sort of just outside of London, very industrial, but had this big, beautiful nature reserve. And that's where I got the original sort of concept and title for the project. So the actual direct quote in the offing, the scene Sky Were Welded, is in reference to the Gravesend strip of the Thames, which is where some of the first photos and the first solograph were located when I was taking those images. I think those are the keys, really.
And did you face any challenges when creating your project?
Yeah, we, funnily enough, so the cameras are basically tin cans that you zip tie up to certain places along the Thames, and then you just leave them. And so the whole time I was terrified that they were going to be, you know, vandalized or removed, or, you know, as you would expect, what would happen if someone comes up across a little can, you know. And for the most part, it was great. It ran really smooth. They were all there until the final collection, where I was with Tim shooting the short documentary for the project. And somehow, the one time they wanted to record me going to collect the cameras, two of the three had been vandalized. One had been smashed, the other had been removed. And the third one, someone had rotated it, so the image was only, it was only caught like half of the image. So that was fun. I had to be on camera as well, which is just like, just what you want, you know?
Yeah, of course.
Other than that though, the project went quite well, like pretty seamlessly. The images that came back were sort of as I expected. Thames were able to support me with some equipment that I was able to use, so it made the whole actual, the post-processing of the imagery made it really seamless as well. But yeah, terrified of the cameras going missing. That was the big thing.
And of course it had to happen at the very end.
Yeah, you know, when the camera's on, like, just
it's like somebody planned it.
You're right. It's what Tim, the guy who was shooting the documentary, is actually what he wanted. He was kind of hoping that there'd be a nice story to tell, you know. And I think it did work out like that, and luckily one of the images was still salvageable. And it's just part of the process, I think, you know, that not knowing.
That sounds like Tim, to be honest.
Yeah.
He loves a bit of drama.
He does.
So after people view your like exhibition, what do you want them to walk away with from it?
I think it's always up to the viewer to sort of take what they want, but I hope that they maybe look into their sort of, they reconsider their own sort of pace in life. They consider how they feel like that time went, how they feel like that moment in life transitioned, and sort of look to the future and see how they can change, or how they can stay the same, or what they enjoy in life. But yeah, for the most part, it's just sort of highlighting this strength, this powerful connection between nature and humankind.
Yeah. And what did you learn from it during this project? Like, did you walk away with any newfound feelings or anything like that?
I mean, it's reignited my love for the Thames. Like, I know that sounds a bit cliche on the totally Thames, you know, but yeah, I live not too far from the Thames, so it's always nice. I've always been down there, but being able to go to these, like, so Tilbury, for example, or being able to get out to Shoebury Ness right at the mouth of the Thames, and sort of learning about this like really unique places that just have their own little bits of history connected to the river and connected to the world. That was amazing. That was definitely the biggest takeaway, I think.
Yeah, sounds amazing. How long is your exhibition on for throughout the festival?
The exhibition is going to be on the Uber boats. There's a specific tagline. Thames Uber by Thames Cliff and Boat.
We'll write it on the description of the video.
Yeah. So they're gonna be on the Uber boats by Thames Clipper, between the 13th and the 19th of September. And then I'm going to try and put an exhibition on later this month, but we'll have to see. Okay. Stay tuned.
Fingers crossed that it works out.
Yeah, thank you. In the meantime though, 13th to the 19th of September on the Uber Boats by Thames Clipper.
And people can book their tickets through the Totally Thames website.
Yes, they can, yeah. And it'll also be online on the Totally Thames website. I think that's going to be a sort of digital exhibition of the work too.
Amazing. Well, thank you so much for taking time to speak to me today.
Yeah, thanks so much.
No worries at all.